So today we are going to learn about second subtopic, that is molecular shape, the definition of Vesper theory. Ini saya sebut VSEPR ni Vesper theory lah. And then draw basic molecular shape and then predict the shape and the bond angle. And then after that you are going to learn about bond dipole and dipole moment. And lastly deduce the polarity, so whether the molecule is polar or non-polar. So before that you have to know what is the meaning by the molecular geometry, right? So what we had already done during the previous class, you already draw the Lewis structure. So Lewis structure that you draw is in 2D dimension and 2D two dimension. So now we want to view the molecular shape according to 3D arrangement. So we are going to use a theory to predict the molecular shape, that is valence shell electron pair repulsion. So short form dia Vesper. Saya sebut Vesper model. What is Vesper theory, right? So this is about the electron. We know that electron pair around the center will repel each other. So the electron will arrange themselves so that it can minimize all the electron pair repulsion. So because of that, we have two kind of electron pair. So as we already known, that is bonding pair electron and lone pair electron. Okay. So the function for Vesper theory here to predict the molecular shape, okay, from the Lewis structure. So meaning that from the Lewis structure you draw in 2D, we use the Vesper theory to draw the actual shape of the molecule. Okay. Alright. So Vesper theory also represent the lowest energy configuration of molecule or polyatomic ion. So it can be molecule and polyatomic ion. Okay, so dia ada syarat-syarat dia lah yang kita kena apply. So first, we have to consider okay, the multiple bond, meaning that double or triple, we count it as one bonding pair. Okay, so bila kita tak kira double bond tu, two bonding pair. Triple bond, three bonding pair, no. So kita kena consider, let's say, double, triple as one bonding pair. Okay, and then all the double, triple, multiple bond has the same effect on bond angle. Thus, as same as single bond. Okay, itu yang kita kena consider, okay, for this theory. And then there are three types of repulsion force. Okay, so there are bonding pair repulsion, non-pair bonding pair repulsion, and lone pair repulsion. But the strongest is lone pair repulsion lah, followed by lone pair bonding pair, and the weakest is bonding pair repulsion. So this type of repulsion, it will affect the shape of the molecule. Eh? So dia kata lone pair of electron repel one another pair. So that's why lone pair repulsion has the strongest repulsion. Okay. So and then you kena consider ni. Eh? So first is about A. A ni is represent as center atom. B is represent the bonding pair electron. E stand for lone pair electron. So this one is to identify the class of molecule lah. So kita akan pakai B berapa lah untuk class of molecule. And then electron pair ni we can define is the total number of bonding pair electron and lone pair electron on the center. Maksudnya semua berapa banyak total electron pair yang ada, bonding pair plus dengan lone pair electron. Okay, electron pair arrangement is determined by number of electron pair. So berapa banyak electron pair yang ada, so dia akan bagi dia punya apa, bentuk dia lah, dari segi bentuk. And then the molecular shape here is the actual shape of the molecule, also known as molecular geometry. Alright, so now we start again. Alright, so what is the shape of the molecular shape of this molecule?
Linear.
So this is linear. Right, correct. And then bond angle here?
180.
And what is the class of compound?
AB2.
Alright, so for two electron pair, only one molecule on one shape that you have to remember. So now we proceed with three. Kalau ada tiga electron pair, apakah shape dia kan?
Alright, so it's all three bonding pair. So example like this. Okay, what is the name of this molecular shape?
Trigonal planar.
Trigonal planar.
Trigonal planar. And how? What is the bond angle here?
120.
Bond angle.
120.
Yes. And then what is the class of compound?
AB3.
Alright, so trigonal planar. So bila saya letak on the plane, you can see all terminal and the center and the terminal is on the plane atas atas. Trigonal because the shape is triangle. Semua atas atas. That's why trigonal planar. Okay. Alright, next. If one lone pair present, so I remove one bonding pair. So here is the lone pair. What would be the shape?
V-shape.
So this is V-shape. So kalau saya terbalikkan, nampak bentuk V-shape. And what's the name for V-shape? Apa dia?
Band shape.
So kalau band shape, and then what is the bond angle here?
Less than 120.
Yes, less than 120 since we have lone pair, bonding pair, repulsion. Which is stronger than lone pair, bonding pair, repulsion. So means for 3 electron pair ada 2 shape lah, you kena ingat eh. Alright, next we move to 4 electron pair like this. So saya letak atas-atas sini. Saya nampak macam apa? What is the name of this shape?
Tetrahedral.
Tetrahedral look like microphone stand, kan?
Alright,
you can see clearly here. Dia punya, tengok. Yang reach the plane on size atas, cuma 3 je. 3 terminal saja. So, lagi 2 center dengan one more terminal, dia hanging kat atas. Okay. So, berapa bond angle dia?
109.5.
Okay, 109.5. And what is the class of compound?
AB4.
Yes.
AB4.
Alright, so now if one non-pair present. Okay, one non-pair present. So I remove one. So I place it on the plane. So what is the name of the shape?
Trigonal pyramid.
Trigonal pyramidal. So you can see here only 3 terminal atom is on the plane and the center is hanging up. So that's why kita akan nampak tapak dia triangle, trigonal. Pyramidal sebab nampak macam piramid lah. So how, what is the bond angle here?
Less than 109.5.
Less than 109.5. And what is the class of compound?
AB3E.
Okay, now if one non-pair present, saya remove lagi satu. So now become like this. What is this?
V-shape band.
So this band. Is V-shape or band. So what is the bond angle here?
Less than 109.5.
Yes, less than 109.5. And what is the class of compound?
AB2E2.
Yes, AB2E2.
AB2E2.
Okay. Alright, so that's all for the 4 electron pair. So we have tetrahedral. Next, trigonal. Trigonal what?
Trigonal
pyramidal. And band or V-shape. Okay, now we move to 5 electron pair. So 5 electron pair. Start with all bonding pair. So we have like this. This is the example, the model. So what is the name of this molecular shape?
Trigonal
pyramidal. Trigonal pyramidal. Nama dia ada trigonal by pyramidal. Trigonal means
segitiga.
Triangle. So nampak kalau saya sambung yang hijau ni, kita akan nampak dia apa? triangle lah. Okay, and then ada satu terminal di atas dan di bawah. So bila kita sambungkan, sambung. So we have one pyramid on top and then the other pyramid at the bottom. And that's why nama dia by me two pyramid. Okay. So how, what is the bond angle here? Sini.
120
90 ah, this is 90.
Oh, 90
daripada atas, daripada atas ni sampai sini, so it's 90 degree. So however for this one
120.
Ah, so untuk yang ada tiga ni dia 120, so dia ada dua sudut lah. Okay, alright, so now if a long time present, so kita tak boleh remove atas atau bawah ni, atas dengan bawah tak boleh. Okay, sebab apa? Sebab dia dekat 90. Sini pun 90, sini 90, bawah 90 kan. So yang paling jauh adalah yang position yang warna hijau ni, 120. So kalau saya remove satu, okay, and then saya letak atas atas macam ni. Okay, so nampak macam apa ni?
Sisa.
DM pun jongkak-jongkik kan. Sisa. Okay. Ataupun nama lain apa selain pada sisa?
Distorted tetrahedral.
Distorted tetrahedral. Okay, so berapa bond angle dari sini sampai sini?
Less than 90.
So less than 90. Right? Why? Because we have long pair. Long pair here and bonding pair. So repulsion stronger. So dia akan tolak lebih rapat. So kalau ada sini?
Less than 120.
Okay. So now saya remove lagi yang kedua. Maksudnya letak satu lagi long pair. Tak boleh juga ambil yang atas dengan yang bawah sebab dia sudut dia 90. Jadi kena ambil yang sudut 120. Ambil kat sini. Okay. Susah pula nampak. Okay, so now dia dapat shape macam ni. Kita panggil apa ni?
T-shape.
So sekali saya rotate macam ni, so nampak T-shape kan? T-shape. So what is the bone angle here?
Less than 90.
Because we have long pair repulsion is stronger than long pair bonding pair repulsion and bonding pair repulsion. Boleh eh? Alright, so saya nak remove lagi satu. So mesti datang daripada apa? Yang kawasan 120. Buang satu lagi. Saya dapatlah bentuk ini. Dia nama apa ni? This is?
Linear.
Berapa bond angle di sini?
180.
Yes, betul. 180. Why? Because dia ada kat sini ada repulsion, long pair repulsion, atas pun ada long pair repulsion, dia tolak ke bawah, yang bawah tolak ke atas, so dia cancel out, jadi sudut dia sama, jadi 180. Okay, boleh faham eh? How many shape that you have to remember for 5 electron pair? Berapa shape? Yang awal ni, we start with AB5. Trigonal, by pyramidal, betul. Next, AB5E, apa nama dia?
Seesaw.
Apa dia? Seesaw. Alright, next, AB3E2.
T-shape.
Linear. So ada empat maksudnya, kan? Alright, so now kita move to 6 electron pair, for example like this. So kita panggil apa ni?
Octahedral.
So AB6, octahedral. Berapa bond angle?
90.
So dia sama-sama, saya pusing sini pun dia semua 90. Dia simetri. Okay, kenapa nama dia octa? Octa tu stand for what?
Octagon.
So lebih kurang macam octagon. Kenapa kita panggil dia octagon? Octa tu apa? Ada 8. Hedral means? Siapa ingat hadron apa maksud hadron? 8 apa? 8? Surface area, permukaan. Hadron permukaan. So, what we tengok? So, yang bahagian atas. So, we have kalau sambungkan. 1, 2, 3. You sambungkan. So, we have one surface area. So, saya pusing. Sambung sini. 2 surface area. 3 surface area. 4 surface area. So, bawah pun ada 4 lah. So, that's why total dia 8 surface area. So, octahedron. Alright, so now. If one non-trapezoid. Okay, saya ambil yang paling jauh atas. Okay. So, what would be? What would it be?
Square pyramid.
So, you can see tapak dia square. Ada satu terminal di atas. So, bentuk dia piramid. Dan sebab tapak dia square, square pyramid lah. Alright, so berapa bond angle? Sini ataupun di sini?
Less than 90,
yes. So now, if one non-trapezoid, so now become like this. So, saya letak on the plane. So, kita panggil apa?
Square planar.
Square planar, eh. Square because of square lah bentuk segi empat. And then planar sebab all the atom including center on the plane. That's why dia planar. Berapa buat angle?
90.
So, dia kekal 90, eh. Because we have repulsion on top and repulsion downwards. So, dia push upward. This one push downward. So, cancel out. So, the bond angle remain the same 90. Okay, boleh? Okay. Alright, so settle for the induction set.
Draw the molecular shape first. You have to draw the Lewis structure. And then, maybe we can check the Lewis structure whether it is the most possible or not by using the formal charge, calculate the formal charge. And then, baru kita identify dia punya kelas AB berapa. Okay, and then baru lukis lah. Okay, itu yang kita nak buat lah. Okay, so the first step, you have to draw the Lewis structure. So, what is the first step that we have to do for the Lewis structure?
Okay, central atom.
So first of all, you have to identify which one is the center atom and which one is the terminal.
Terminal.
Right? Yeah. So between beryllium and chlorine, which is the center atom? So beryllium. Eh? So what are the characteristic that to become the center atom? Center ingat lagi apa hari tu? More electro?
Oh, positive.
Okay. So center atom. So usually the characteristic it should be more positive lah. More electropositive. Okay, whereas for the terminal atom, it should be what? More electro negative, eh? Okay, and then so there are certain case the atom always become the terminal. So what are the example?
Hydrogen,
yes. Hydrogen always become the terminal. Ada lagi satu, apa dia?
Chlorine.
Okay. So usually center is carbon lah. Ini contoh dia lah, so ingat balik. Right, so first of all, you have to draw the center. Okay, and then the terminal. And then you have to draw the single bond. Okay, after that, what should we do? So we calculate the total number of valence electron. So beryllium.
Two.
And then Cl, we have 2Cl times 7. So 7 times 2 is equal to 14. So you just plus. So we get here 16 minus berapa?
2.
2. Are you sure 2?
4.
Minus 4. So then we get here is 12. Next, what should we do?
Letak dekat terminal atom.
So kita kena octetkan dulu apa terminal. So how many electron that we have already used?
12.
So dah tak ada lah. Okay, now look at the the center atom? Is it a chief octet?
No.
So do we have to octet the beryllium? So remember, so we have three atom, center atom that is not apa a chief octet. That is beryllium, boron and aluminium. So you just leave like this lah. So if you're not sure, then you can calculate the or charge. Okay, for example like Cl. So Cl we have 7 valence electron. So 7 minus 7 kan? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So equals to 0. So beryllium is 2. Okay, 2 minus. For the bonding pair electron, we just count 1. So 1, 2 equals to 0. So same thing goes to Cl, 7 minus 7 equals to 0. So this is already stable lah. Okay. So now we have to write the class of molecule, right? So we have ABE as the center atom, and then we have two bonding pair. Okay, so B 2. So AB 2 is linear. Okay, now we draw the linear shape. So when we draw the molecular shape, okay, for the lone pair on the terminal, no need to draw. So just leave like this. Okay, and then what is the bond angle?
180.
180. Okay. So what type of bond? Type of repulsion? Is this here? Since the center atom is not don't have any lone pair, so only bonding pair. So the type of repulsion is bonding pair, bonding pair repulsion.
Alright, next kita cuba buat ni pula AlCl3. Okay. So since Al is more electropositive, macam mana saya tahu dia more electropositive? Sebab Al kan metal. Jadi metal kan more electropositive. So Al di tengah, Cl is the terminal. Okay. So Al kena kira 1 times 3 equals to 3. Cl we have 3 times 7 equals to 21. Ditambah dapatlah berapa? 24. Next tolak dengan bonding pair 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So kita ada berapa? Baki dia ada 18 kan? So now buat apa? Completekan octet for the terminal. Okay, so we already use how many electron?
18.
18 electron. That's correct. So no more electron left. Okay, so and then this one the center memang tak perlu octetkan dia kan? Since dia adalah under apa? Incomplete octet.
Incomplete octet.
Ha, ni pun incomplete octet. So dia ada 6 electron. Okay, nanti you boleh kira lah form charge ya. Alright, now kita nak tentukan kelas. A for the center, B main bonding pair. We have 1, 2, 3 bonding pair. So the shape would be trigonal planar. So macam mana kita lukis? Kita lukis kat atas ni bukan ya trigonal planar, tak nampak pun triangle dia kan. So kita akan lukis begini lah. Macam triangle. CL, CL, CL. So untuk yang long pair dekat terminal tak perlu lukis. Just biar begini je. Tapi kalau ada kat center long pair wajib lukis lah. Kalau tak dia tak stable pula. Tak cukup octet. So bond angle here is 120. So can you give me what is the type of repulsion as this here?
BP, BP.
BP, BP.
Sama kan? Sebab dia kat center tak ada long pair. Okay, now kita cuba yang ni pula. O3, ozone. Okay, since all are the same, maksudnya terminal dengan apa center sama lah kan? Okay, oksigen. So kita ada 3. 18. Okay, minus. Kita lukis single bond. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so ada baki 14. So next, you draw the compare. Ada terminal. Kita dah guna 12 kan? Ada baki 2. Apa nak buat ni? 2 baki ni. 2 elektron.
Kita nak buat elektron.
Center atom. Kalau kita kira balik, center atom ni dia tak cukup kan? Dia ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Boleh tak kita biar je?
Tak boleh.
So kalau tak pasti, so kita boleh kira. Cuba kita kira dia punya form of charge. Jadi structure ni tak stable. Jadi kena buat double bondkan dia. So ambil lah kiri atau kanan, pindahkan. So bila kita pindahkan, next kita akan dapat lah sini double bond. So sini baki tinggal 2 lompat sajalah ya. Okay. Now we want to identify the class. So this is A. So remember kalau ada double atau triple bond, kita consider dia sebagai one bonding pair. So maksudnya dalam structure ni ada satu bonding pair, dua bonding pair. So A, B tu lah. Okay, and then ada satu long pair kat sini. Long pair ada satu kat sini. So that's why dia jadi E. Ada E. A, B tu E. So what is the shape for A, B tu E?
V shape.
V shape, yes, correct. Ataupun nama lain dia band. Okay, so now kita nak lukis. So dia punya arrangement, the elektron lebih kurang sama macam trigonal planar. Tapi kita letak lone pair tu di salah satu tempat lah. Let's see, saya letak dekat atas ni. Alright, so lone pair kat sini. Ni double bond. So remember, untuk yang terminal, terminal ni tak perlulah kita lukis long pair dia. Tapi kalau center, center ada long pair macam ni, wajiblah kita letak dan lukis. Kalau tak, dia tak cukup octet. Right, so berapa bond angle di sini? Berapa?
Less than 120.
Yes, less than 120. Less than 120. Alright, so now kita nak ni type of repulsion ni. Identify type of repulsion. So anyone?
Sebut bond pair, bond pair.
Bonding pair, bonding pair. Lagi?
Lone pair,
bond pair, lone pair.
Lone pair. Which one is the strongest?
Lone pair, bonding pair.
Bond pair.
Yeah, ni ini yang the strongest. Okay, that's why dia punya sudut dia tak sama dengan yang trigonal planar tadi. Tadi 120 kan, sekarang kurang daripada 120. Okay, so now for this example, CHCl3. Yang mana satu akan jadi center?
C.
Carbon. Carbon always become the center. Hydrogen always become the what?
Terminal.
Yes. Kenapa dia always become the terminal?
More electropositive.
So more electropositive, yes. And it achieve duplet. Dia tak boleh achieve octet. Sebab apa tak boleh achieve octet?
Sebab dia ada satu terminal elektron je.
Sebab dia ada satu elektron and located in n equals to 1. So bila n equals to 1, dia cuma ada apa? 1s sahaja. Paling maksimum boleh sumbat berapa? 2 sahaja. Okay, now kita nak identify the class. So this is A. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 bonding pair. So this is AB4. So the name here is tetrahedral. Okay. Right, so mana nak lukis dia? Lukis dia bayangkan macam microphone stand. So maksudnya kaki ada 3 kat bawah. Ada satu kaki kat atas. Macam ni. And then hydrogen ni terpulang. Nak letak mana-mana pun tak kisah. Let's see, saya letak kat atas. Okay. Okay, lepas tu yang selebihnya CL. So remember, down pair dekat terminal tak perlu lukis. Berapa bond angle di sini?
109.5.
Yes, correct. So can you give me the type of repulsion axis here?
BP, BP.
And F3. So which one would become the terminal? Kau nampak ni dah tahu dah. F is the most electronegative atom. So it always become the terminal lah. Jadi kita lukis N center, F is the terminal. Like this. Okay, draw the single bond. And then kira lah berapa. Nitrogen is located in group 15. So 5 valence electron. Fluorine, we have 3. 7 valence electron. Tambah. So sekarang ada 26. Tolak. So kita lukis single bond. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So ada 20. So complete kan octet. So remember kenapa saya nak tunjuk banyak kali lukis-lukis restructure kan. Supaya awak faham dan awak ingat lah. So cara dia nak ingat satu je, dia kena buat latihan. Cuba lukis sendiri kan. Right, so we already use 18. We have balance another 2. What should we do?
Letak kat center.
Letak kat center.
Betul-betul. Letak kat center. Okay, now kita nak identify dia punya kelas. So A for the center. B for the bonding pair. 1, 2, 3. So ada 3 bonding pair. And then the center atom have 1 lone pair. So that's why A, B, 3, E. Okay, the shape here is trigonal. Apa dia?
Pyramidal.
Yes,
pyramidal.
Betul. Pyramidal. Okay, so macam mana cara kita lukis lebih kurang macam yang ni tadi. Cuma kita gantikan yang H ni, kita ganti dengan long pair. Jadi maksudnya sini ada long pair. Lepas tu dia tiga kaki. F, F, F. So bond angle dia berapa kat sini?
Less than 109.5.
Yes, less than 109.5. Okay, sekarang give me the type of repulsion axis here.
BP, BP. BBP.
BP, BP. Lagi?
LPBP.
LPBP, yes, betul. Okay, and the strongest here is?
LPBP.
LPBP.
Yes, ni yang paling kuat. That's why sudut dia kurang. Kurang daripada yang tadi tu lah. Okay, kita try lagi. H2O. Right, so first of all, hydrogen yang kita tahu. Must always become the terminal. Tak payah fikir panjang. Terminal here. Ada oksigen. Sini ada H. Jadi kita kira lah. So we have balance 4. What should we do? Ada 4 baki ni.
Letak dekat oksigen.
Letak di dekat oksigen, betul. Macam ni. Alright, so now kita nak tentukan dia punya kelas. Kelas of compound. So this is A. So there are 2 bonding pair. A, B, 2. And then we have 2 long pair. So E, 2. So this is what we call, apa nama dia? A, B, 2, E, 2.
Band or V shape.
Betul-betul. Band ataupun V shape. Alright, so sekarang kita nak lukis. So dia nak nampakkan dia V shape kan. So maksudnya kita akan letak 2 long pair tu dekat center lah macam ni. So sini satu, sini satu. So this is H and this is H. Alright, so berapa bond angle kat sini?
Less than 109.5.
Yes, less than 109.5. Can you give me the type of repulsion present here?
BP. BP, BP.
Okay, BPBP lagi.
LPBP.
LPBP ada lagi tak?
LPLP.
Yes, betul. So the strongest here is
LPLP.
LPLP.
PF5. Which one would be the center?
P.
Di mana akan jadi center?
P.
P eh? Saya tahu nampak je F ni confirm dah lah. Mestilah akan jadi apa? Terminal kan? Okay. Alright, next. Sekira. Phosphorus. Kita nak tentukan kelas. So A, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bonding pair. A, B, 5. So bentuk dia adalah trigonal apa? Bipyramidal. So ingat ejaan dia BI eh, bukan BY. Bipyramidal. So nak lukis macam mana pula ya? So we lukis center, lepas satu atas, satu bawah macam ni. Itu satu di kanan macam ni, macam star lah. And then F. Okay, okay, and then long pair at the terminal, no need to draw eh. So now kita nak start dia punya bond angle. Berapakah bond angle di sini?
90.
Okay, 90. How about this? 20. Okay, type of repulsion.
BP, BP.
Atas.
Okay, only one right? BP, BP. Bonding pair, bonding pair, repulsion. Okay, so K-ion eh. So, I would become the center lah. Okay, and then we have CN. It's the terminal. And then you draw single bond. And then baru kita kira lah. Pi, 1 times 7 equal to 7. So we have CL, CL berapa? Ada 4. So 28 ditambah berapa? 35, right? So what should you do for the ion?
Kena tolak.
Kita kena tolak. Berapa kita kena tolak?
1 elektron.
Tolak satu elektron. So sebab dia ke ion kan? Ke ion mestilah dia kurang elektron. Bila kurang tolak lah. Tolak satu. Kenapa tolak satu? Sebab dia positive one. So now become 34. Lepas tu baru kita tolak. Barulah kita tolak dengan bonding pair. So ada 8 kan? And then nak bezakan, kita nak bezakan antara, kita nak bezakan kompon dengan ion. So kita kena lukis square bracket, buat kurungan macam ni. And then charge dia letak kat luar lah macam ni. Begini. Baru nampak beza antara kompon dengan ion. Okay, next kita nak tentukan dia punya kelas. So A, kita tengok bonding pair ada 1, 2, 3, 4. So A, B, 4. And then we have one long pair. Ada satu long pair di sini kan? So A, B, 4. P. So what is the shape of this molecule? A, B, 4, E.
Seesaw.
Distorted.
Yes. Wow, dengar suara Din. Seesaw. So kita akan ambil kat mana? Position yang mana? Yang 90 degree atas bawah ni kau? Nak letak lompeh? Atau yang sepatu 20 ni? Mana nak letak lompeh? Atas, bawah? Okay, ataupun pada sudut yang 120? Okay, Fred. Mana nak letak ni? Atas bawah? Okay. Right, so kalau atas dan di bawah, so dia jarak dia, maksudnya dia punya sudut 90 kan? Sudut dia lebih rapat dengan 3 lagi bonding pair ni. Maksudnya dia akan ada berlaku repulsion tu kuat lah. Jadi kita tahu kalau Vesper teori dia apa, yang elektron tu dia mesti arrange themselves as far as possible to minimize the repulsion. Jadi tak boleh ambil dari sini pun tak boleh, kan? Yang boleh position ini. Yang ini, ini ataupun ini. So yang atas bawah ni cannot. Sebab sudut dia 90. Yang ni antara ni dengan ni dia 120 jauh. Jadi repulsion dia lebih lebih kurang lah. Kurang lah repulsion dia. Lemah lah. Jadi kita akan letak sini long pair. Sini lagi adalah dia punya terminal lah. Okay, so ini pun sama. You have to draw square bracket and also the charge. Okay, now kita nak tentukan dia punya sudut sini berapa. Apa sudut dia sini? Less than 120. Sudut kat sini?
Less than 90.
Less than 90, yes, correct. So now nak tentukan type of repulsion. Nah, lama dah tak muat dah. Boleh kat sini lah. Type of repulsion. Okay, so we have boy BPBP lagi. Satu je.
LPBP.
LPBP. And the strongest here is?
LPBP.
Ini. IDR3. Right, so between I and the R, which one is more electropositive?
I.
So kalau kita position dia, dia start with F. Lepas tu bawah ada CL. Lepas tu ada BR kan? Dan sekali baru I. So meaning I is more electropositive lah. So therefore I would become the center lah. Okay, so I center. So kita okay lah I center. Okay, next you have to calculate the total number of valence electron. So I. Okay, next we want to identify the class. So this is A for the center. So B stand for the bonding. So we have 1, 2, 3. And then E stand for the long pair. So we have 2 long pair here. So what is the shape of this molecule?
T shape.
So this is T shape. Alright, so lukislah. So I. So remember, so for the long pair, so dia ada 3 je position yang you boleh letak. So position yang dekat bahagian 120, sudut 120. So in order to look like a T-shape, so kita akan letak sini lah. 1, 2. Okay. Sini kita akan letak dia punya long pair. So and then we'll draw the terminal, R. Right, so as for remember, so long pair at the center memang kena lukis ya. Kalau tak dia, bila kita kira former charge tu dia tak dapat zero lah kan. Okay, and then the terminal, no need to draw the long pair. Okay, now we want to identify the bond angle. Berapa bond angle di sini?
60.
So this one sebab because we have repulsion, long pair, long pair repulsion. So, bond angle become less than 90. Alright, next, identify the type. So, what is the type of repulsion present here?
Long pair, long pair.
Okay, long pair, yes, correct. Next.
Bonding pair.
And the strongest is?
Long pair.
Okay, yeah. Right, so now we move to this one Contoh A, B to E. So I3 mana? Contoh an ion lah. Tadi ke ion. Sekarang kita tengok contoh an ion. This one. So macam biasa. So because of all the all the atom is the same. So terminal dengan center sama lah. I lah semua. Okay, next we calculate the valence electron total. 21. So however, this is an ion. After we calculate the total number of valence electron, what should we do?
Tolak satu.
Sebetul ke tolak satu?
Tambah satu.
So ingat ion less electron. So that's why kat sini kita tolak tadi. Tolak. So anion more electron. So that's why sini kita kena tambah. Tambah berapa tengok dia punya charge. Last one. So before right here we have 22. Right next minus 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have another 18. Right next you have to complete the terminal. So we already use 12. However we have balance and a 6. What should we do?
Letak kat center.
Yes. Ada baki letak di center. Okay. Right, don't forget to draw the square bracket because this is ion. Now we want to identify the class. So this is A for the center. Okay, and then B stand for the bonding. We have 1, 2. And then E stand for the lone pair. So we have 1, 2, 3 lone pair. So there are 3 lone pair. Okay. So the class of compound is AB to E. So what is the shape?
Linear.
So this is linear. Right, so you boleh lukis sama ada macam ni, bentuk begini ataupun bentuk menegak pun tak kisahlah, mana-mana pun boleh. Cuma perbezaan dia, kalau kita lukis molecular shape, so kita tak perlu dah nak lukis yang lompat dekat terminal tu. Tapi dekat center wajib lah. Ni wajib lukis. Ya, dekat terminal tak perlu dah. Okay. Alright, so now we want to identify the type of repulsion.
Bond pair.
So kalau tengok tadi I is paling bawah sekali kan. O yang paling dekat dengan F. Jadi so I would become the. Right next you can count the total number of valence electron. Okay, so and then kita completekan lah dia punya terminal, octetkan dia. So we already use 6 times 36. So no more electron left. Okay. Right, so sekarang kita try kira dia punya apa tu? Form of charge. Betul tak structure dia macam ni kan? Right, so we start with Cl. Tengok Cl 7 valence electron. So 7 minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 ni kan? So sama dengan 0. Means all the Cl all 0 lah. Sebab dia semua identical. So now we focus on oxygen. Oxygen 6. So means 6 minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Negative 1 kan? So tengok pula iodine ni. Tengah ni. Iodine 7. So 7 minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So means dia baru ada, dia positive 1. So kat sini lah ada apa yang tak stable. Dia tak kosong kan. Ada dua yang tak kosong. Maksudnya oksigen dengan iodine ni. So therefore you kena pindahkan lah. Jadikan dia kosong. Jadi pindahkan mana-mana. Lompat pada O. Pindahkan ke sini. Okay, so therefore kita akan dapat new structure, the double bond. Class of compound. So AB berapa ni?
AB.
Class of compound. A, B. So double bond, remember double bond ni kita consider dia sebagai apa? So dia consider dia one bonding pair. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is AB 6. The shape here is apa dia?
Octahedral.
Betul, octahedral. Okay, so now kita lukis. Lukis ya. So R in the center. So lukis dia, this look like a star. Ha, tapi ada 6 macam ni kan. Lepas tu letak je lah si L. Yang O ni letak mana-mana pun tak kisah. Let's say saya letak kat sini kan. O. So dia terminal tu tak perlulah lukis dia punya lompat. Okay, now kita identify the bond angle. Berapakah bond angle di sini?
90 degree,
yes, correct. So now we want to identify the type of repulsion.
PPPP.
So they only have one type, seeing the center atom does not have any lompat. Okay, kita try lagi dua ni. Okay. So BR and CL. So BR ni bawah CL. So therefore BR is the center lah. Okay, next you calculate the valence electron. Octetkan terminal. Alright, next kita akan tentukan dia punya kelas. So this is A. So and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. AB5. Okay, ada satu long pair kat sini kan. Sini long pair. So AB5E. So what is the name of this molecular shape?
Square pyramidal.
Square pyramidal.
Yes, correct. Square pyramidal. Okay, next lukis. Kita nak lukis macam mana? Nak nampakkan dia square. So yang dekat bawah ni kita letak lompat dia. So VR bawah ni dia punya lompat lah. So yang lain tu dia punya terminal. So center kalau ada lompat wajib dah lukis. Okay, now kita nak tentukan bond angle berapa?
Less than 90.
Okay, alright, correct. Type of repulsion.
Bond pair.
So which one is the strongest?
Bond pair.
This is the strongest. Okay. Right, lastly kita nak lukis yang ni pula. XE. Ini group berapa? Siapa ingat?
18.
Group 18. So therefore it has 8 valence electron. So and then you complete dia punya terminal dia. Okay, now kita tentukan dia punya class. So this is A. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. A, B, 4. And then we have 2 lone pair. 1 lone pair, 2 lone pair. So A, B, 4 itu. Apa nama dia? Square planar. So bila kita lukis tu, kita akan letak lone pair tu atas dengan bawah lah. XE. Ni lone pair di atas, bawah. Lepas lagi dua tu dia punya bonding pair F. Okay, now nak tentukan dia punya bond angle. Berapa ni? Berapa bond angle di sini?
90.
So this one dia tak seperti yang AB5E ya. Sebab walaupun dia ada long pair, tapi long pair di bawah dia tolak ke atas. Long pair yang atas tolak ke bawah. So cancel out, remain lah 90 degree. So now yang missing type of repulsion.
Bonpe.
Strongest is here. Then
Lonpe.
Okay, yang ni eh. Okay. Alright, so dah settle lah untuk molekula shape, settle dah.